Meghan Markle and Prince Harry's honeymoon, a look back at royal wedding getaways. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle are just 3 months away from tying the royal knot in May the year. Before the engaged couple take the final step towards the rest of their lives, here is a look back at a history of royal honeymoons. Prince Harry, 33, and his actress fiancée Meghan Markle, 36. Will host their royal nuptials in Windsor this upcoming May. Though the happy couple has shied away from revealing their honeymoon destination, speculation has been rife about where they might go. Among the most likely royal getaway choices are the lush Caribbean island of Nevis and Harry's beloved Botswana in Africa. Other endearing options include Hawaii, Jamaica, and Meghan's favorite, Italy. But as the couple settle on a destination for their honeymoon, where have other members of the royal family escaped to for some post-wedding privacy? Queen Elizabeth and Prince Philip. Britain's favorite monarch married the love of her life in a post-World War II Britain in 1947, and as such the Queen's honeymoon destination was less than exotic. The newlyweds chose to spend their time together in a place that was very close to their hearts, Broadlands in Hampshire. The Broadlands are home to Prince Philip's family, the Mountbattens. The couple then deeded to head to Aberdeenshire where they spent some quiet time together at the Birch Hall Estate in Royal Deeside, Scotland. Birch Hall was bought in 1715 by Prince Albert and was one of the homes in which the Queen grew up as a young child. Prince Charles and Princess Diana. The newlyweds followed in the footsteps of the Queen and the Duke of Edinburgh and spent the first 3 days of their honeymoon in the Broadlands in 1981. But thereafter the couple took off to the warmer parts of the globe, notably to Gibraltar where they undertook an 11-day cruise of the Mediterranean. Cruising the warm waters of southern Europe on board the royal yacht Britannia, Charles and Diana paid visit to Tunisia, Sardinia, Greece, and Egypt. However, at the end of their sunny trip, they returned home to Balmoral Castle where they spent some much-needed time with their family at a hunting lodge on the estate. Prince William and Kate Middleton. Thought it seemed as if Kate and William's fairy tale wedding could not have been outdone by anything, the couple flew to the magical Seychelles in East Africa. The happy pair initially kept a tight lid on their honeymoon destination of choice and the whole affair was shrouded in mystery. A spokesperson for the royal family later released a statement on their behalf, saying, "The couple thoroughly enjoyed their time together, and they are grateful to the Seychelles government for their assistance in making the honeymoon such a memorable and special 10 days. It was later revealed that the prince and his bride stayed in a luxurious £5,000 a night villa with its own freshwater pool, personal chef, butler and private garden. Rumor has it Kate and William visited Seychelles in 2007 where they secretly vowed to each other to tie the knot one day. Prince Andrew and Sarah Ferguson. The Queen's third child followed his older brother, Charles, and took the Duchess of York on board the royal yacht Britannia to the Azores Islands in 1986. The happily married couple took off to Heathrow Airport in an open carriage alongside a king-sized teddy bear and a faux satellite dish with a sign attached reading "Phone Home," placed there by Prince Edward as a joke. After sailing to the scenic Portuguese islands, the Duke and Duchess of York spent their 5-day honeymoon on board Britannia out in the Atlantic.